Now, when we look over at TradingView, make sure before we start this that you've seen the previous two videos that I've made on the channel here about how to use TradingView. I'm not going to explain too many of the basics here. We're just going to explain how to close this entry in pieces. What you see here at the changeover of day is, number one, spreads are massive. As usual, it's 15 pips right now on GBP CAD. But because this is not a real trade, we're on a paper trading account, and because that has nothing to do with the purpose of this video, I didn't care to make it at any specific time of day. But what I want to show you here is that we have about 500,000 units of currency in, actually 495,000. What that translates to is not 495,000 lots, it's actually a 4.95 lot size. The way you can think of this is whenever you see 100,000, that's one standard lot. So a 5 lot would be the same thing as 500,000 units of currency. So in a situation like this, I'm short GBP CAD 495,000 units, and my price is 1.73682. You can see my stop loss above, but let's just say as the trade develops against me, as it's going negative now, I took this position before we started the video specifically because I was like, I needed to go against me so we can close it. Let's just say as we normally would, when a trade isn't developing in your favor, you can actually take a look at this entry and try to close it here through your protect position, but you won't be able to. You would think, let me click to protect position and it should let me close some of it. It doesn't. What it asks you to do then here, you see in the top right, is adjust your stop loss and adjust your take profit. So what are you gonna do? How do you find it? Well, let's check at the bottom. You see there's an X. I know that's gonna close the position. I see the profit here. I see the stop loss. I see a little drawing tool. Maybe that's it. Nope, that's literally the same thing. Okay, so how do we do this? Well, it's simple. Remember, we're trading in units of the currency. So if we're short, if we're selling GBP CAD, how do we get rid of that sell? How do we close that sell? We buy back units of the currency. So in this situation, let's just say I wanted to close half of it. What I would do is I would round up the 495,000 to 500,000. I'd come to the quantity here and I would type in half of 500,000, which is 250,000. And because we're short, I would put in a buy order. I'd click buy, and then right there, you can see we're now down to 245,000 units. Let's say, for example, I wanna close just the 45,000 units. Again, change the quantity, hit buy, and because we're short, it closes some of my position. It buys back some of those units. Now with 200,000 left, let's just say I wanna close the whole thing, hit the X, and we're out. Let me flip this around and just show you a buy. So let's buy 100,000 units right now. Perfect. Let's just say, blah, 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 trade's going well. We want to close it in profit as things are working out great. Let's close 60,000 units. So what do? We don't buy it again. That's going to put another long position in. You sell it back because you bought it previously. So we sell 60,000 and it'll take us down to 40,000 units. It's that simple. You can do the same exact thing on the FX Trade app. You guys know I have it down here. You can do it on your phone in the same way, but that's how you close in units. So, and that's how you can piece your way out of these trades, closing in units. All you have to do is remember 100,000 units is a standard and it goes down from there.